me pregunta mi pensamiento. Los campos son casi iguales. Los dos se marchitan con sequedades, pero lloviendo, el amor y los campos van floreciendo. Se muere queriendo, va derechito a la gloria. Deja lo que digan, y de mi forma en historia, que el que se muere queriendo, va derechito a la gloria. Se iguala. Deja lo que digan, y de mi forma en historia, que el que se muere queriendo va derechito a la gloria. Deja lo que digan, y de mi forma en historia, que el que se muere queriendo va derechito a la gloria. Deja lo que digan, y de mi forma en historia, que el que se muere queriendo va derechito a la gloria. Se muere queriendo, va derechito a la gloria. Ay, ay, ay. Pregúntale al platero, que cuando.
Muchas gracias. Muchas gracias. Thank you very much. How many people here speak Spanish? Ah, sí. How many again? Not everybody. Almost. Okay. Bueno, pues buenos días, buenas tardes. Nosotras somos las migas Good afternoon. We are Las Migas. We come from Barcelona, and we are touring for 1 month around the States and Central America. And this is our, we have 3 more concerts before we go home. So today and tomorrow. See, this today is the 12th concert. So we are kind of tired already. But we are very happy to be here in this university city and very different of the other places where we have been. Our music is flamenco music mixed up with other styles as Latin music, classical music, jazz. I think you will hear a bit of a lot of different styles because we don't like to just stay in one music, but we love all the world music from the very different places. So this is what we are trying to do in our own style. This group was born in 2004, so very long time ago already, but we have been changing styles, people, so it's very alive. We have 3 different albums, and our last one was released 1 year ago. It's called Vente Conmigo, and we are very happy because it has been nominated to the Latin Grammys, so that means that we'll be in Las Vegas very soon to see if we win it or not. We started with a traditional song, flamenco lyrics that are not ours, but they are like popular music, popular lyrics with my own composition. It's called Déjalos que digan. It means let them talk, something about love. Like all our songs are love songs, actually. And we are going to continue with another of our new songs called Vente Conmigo, Come With Me.
Vente conmigo, ya haremos.
conmigo y haremos y una chocita en el campo.
Viene ya.
Si mi madre no me casa este domingo que viene, le meto fuego a la casa que con todo está lo que tiene. Le meto fuego a la casa que con todo y todo lo que
vente
tiene.
Vente conmigo y haremos.
Chocita en el campo,
viene ya, no me
pero que vente conmigo y haremos.
Vente conmigo
y una chocita en el campo,
viene ya, no me
pero que vente conmigo.
Vente conmigo
y una chocita con pañuelito mío que tiene el campo,
viene ya, no
y vente conmigo y haremos.
Viene ya, no me tenemos.
Gracias. Hello, how are you? I don't see nothing here. It's... Ah, great, that's better. Okay, I'm going to explain you a little bit this part of my violin solo. It's very easy, in fact. I was thinking about what to do with my violin alone, and I thought that there is a very important instrument which is called loop station. I don't know if some of you knows about that. I don't know, maybe not. Loop station, never heard. Okay. So I'm going to show you, and this solo, violin solo, is I thought at the beginning to do a part. The first part is, and I was inspired. Thank you. Inspired with Armand Amar music. Maybe some of you knows. No. Okay. You should listen Armand Amar. I think this is very, very beautiful music for the soul. And I thought to do something inspired with this kind of music, with duduk. It's a Liban instrument from there. It's a very beautiful sound. So this first part is about this kind of music, Oriental music. And the second part, there is Alicia guitar, who plays bulerias, the rhythm of the flamenco, this kind of bulerias. Can you maybe only to show them, give something? Okay. So with this rhythm, I try to do something with her guitar, like not really flamenco violin. It's maybe some jazz music, you will see. So it's not really flamenco, but the guitars of Alicia is really the bulerias, the rhythm of flamenco, and me, I am going to say something with her. Okay, so I start.
Thank you. Thank you. Song talks about, for those who don't understand the lyrics in Spanish, talks about patio. How would be patio in English? There is no translation. There is a place in the house, like open air, because in Spanish is a warm weather, so
like
there is
the garden?
Some place. No. No, not a garden, but something like this.
Yeah.
Maybe there is translation. Not a garden, but something in this inside the house, but open air. Some patio.
Patio?
It's called patio.
Did you say
in
patio?
English?
Really?
Yes.
Patio.
Ah.
Okay. So this song talks about patio, patio, from where you used to live when you were a child. So it's kind of remembering this. You to complain on it.
Tú te acuerdas, patio, cuando de pequeña siempre me quedaba dormía en tu escalera. De cuántas veces jugando a escondidas me dabas cobijo tras de tu esquina.
Tienen frío.
frío, te has quedado solo patio y te has quedado vacío.
Muchas gracias. We're going to play now a guitar piece from one of the most famous guitar players we had in flamenco guitar, called Agustín Sabicas. He was from Spain, from Pamplona, but he was living very long time in New York. And I think he was one of the biggest inspirations for Paco de Lucía. So for you, this piece is called Ritmos de Sabicas.
Thank you.
Gracias. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Bueno, pues ahora, si hablo español, ¿me entendéis? ¿La mayoría?
Maybe ¿sí? We can translate a little bit.
Yes. Now we are going to play the last song. Vamos a tocar una canción muy tradicional, del género más tradicional, que se llaman tangos de Triana. En el flamenco hay una cosa muy, muy importante, que es el ritmo. Y uno de los instrumentos más peculiares, pero más importantes dentro del flamenco, son las palmas y la profesión de palmeros. ¿Quieres tú traducir?
Yeah, because she's saying that the rhythm is one of the most important things in flamenco music. And clapping is really important, as you have seen before. And doing palmas like this, like clapping, is like a profession. You can do it clapping for a living in Spain. It's kind of weird, but it is.
Entonces queremos enseñaros dos de los sonidos más típicos de palmas que tenemos, con un ritmo que se llaman tangos, que es un ritmo que tenemos cuatro beats. This rhythm called tangos, and it's a rhythm with four beats. La primera palma que vamos a aprender es esta, que se llama sorda, que es simplemente hacerlo suavecito.
It's a soft one. It's we call like deaf.
Es solo con las palmas de las manos, no con los dedos, solo con las palmas se juntan y es un sonido flojito. Esta es la palma sorda.
Nice.
Y esta es la palma sonora. Que aquí sí que los dedos. Esta mano tiene que ir un poquito. No. Esta mano no está rígida.
It's like relax.
Yes.
You relax.
Esta mano está relajada y esta es la que hace la presión sobre la palma. Entonces, esta fija pero relajada y la otra es la que se mueve. Muy bien. Y el ritmo es así. El primer beat lo vamos a dar con el pie en el suelo, que también es muy típico en el flamenco, dar el golpe fuerte en el suelo con el pie. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Y el otro. Perfecto. Ahora vamos a tocar una canción y vamos a ir introduciendo palmas sordas y palmas sonoras.
After this song, maybe we can do some, if you have some questions, we are open to explain you whatever you want to know about our music or our lives. Very interesting. No, so we finish, and if you have any questions, we happy to answer.
Y no me cuente pena. No me cuente pena, que a mí no me importa. Fuiste amor de un día, sin dolor.
Thank you.
yo mi abuelo Franco. Ya mi abuelita Carmela, arréglate que nos vamos a tomar cafelito a Utrera. Ya la, ya la reolina. Ya la reolina, su compadre Rafael, no esperaba ya en la esquina. Estoy viviendo entre nubes, lo mismo que el aguacero, pero tus ojos azules me están matando de celos, pero tus ojos azules me están matando de celos. Y ahí, 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 te ganaste que te llegué.
El mes de los caracoles.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you. Muchas gracias.
Thank you. You have some questions about something?
Ah. Alba and me, we know each other for, I think, more than 10 years. Yes, very long. We met in school when we were studying flamenco. She was studying flamenco singing and I was studying guitar in the only university, let's say, that you can do flamenco now. And then Alicia and Rosé, we met them later because we were looking for the best guitar and violin players. And so we, via Facebook, we were like looking everywhere in Spain until we found them. We were looking for good players, but also good people. And so this is kind of 5 years ago.
Mm. Yes?
We have a question from one of our online viewers that asks, what's your favorite place to play?
Mm. Our favorite place that we would like to play or that we have done already?
Yeah, we have done. I think maybe we are always very excited. We play like at home when you know people, you love people who is in the audience. Maybe Barcelona is one of the most favorite places to play. But really, we have always a really great audience. Yeah, they are really nice with us.
Okay, we start in Miami 3 weeks ago. Yes. Mm. Okay. And after we've been in Guatemala, Nicaragua, Honduras, El Salvador, to the part of Central America. And after we have been
in California,
Sacramento, Escondido,
Phoenix.
Thank you.
Portland,
yes.
Kent, Yakama, Washington,
Yakama, Kent. And here.
And we still have to go to
San Valley and New York. We finish the tour.
And then we will go home to get sick.
Yes.
For a week.
To die.
Yes.
And I came away with the feeling that I was listening to a package sort of word, and that the locals listen to a very different kind of flamenco. Is that true?
I don't think so. I think it's true that you were in a tourist place for sure, but the best dancers and players and singers who are living in Sevilla, they do play in these kind of places for living. I mean, they have really nice shows. I don't know if you liked it, but I think
it was very good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
No. No, I think this is, I mean, of course they do something very traditional or like, but this, you might have been the best for sure in that time, because the people who live from flamenco, they travel sometimes, but the flamenco music is not like really easy to live, like any music, I think. So the flamenco players go to these kind of places to play every night, so they get better and better and better. No? Mm-hmm. She lives in Sevilla, she knows more. I come from Sevilla, but I was always in another kind of scene. But we always say that the people who play really nice, they are in those kind of places, so I think you were right to be there. We met there. I mean, we live there. Alba come from there. I live there. Alicia live there. Those we both are from the south, and actually Alba's family is also from the south. So this flamenco is always coming somewhere from the south. But in flamenco in Barcelona, there is also a flamenco scene. Very good players like Miguel Poveda, Duquende, like really famous people come from there. But it's true that traditionally the south was the beginning, but now I think flamenco is all around the world, mm-hmm. even not even just Spain, but in New York you have really high level, Japan, all these kind of places. Mm. Hmm.
What a deep question.
Bueno, para nosotras, pues, bueno, es nuestra forma de vida y es nuestro. Para nosotras no lo consideramos tampoco un trabajo, es algo que lo tomas en tu vida como un canal de expresión. Yo personalmente suelto muchísimas cosas con la música, tanto en momentos buenos como malos. Y nosotras, pues, nos estamos completamente dedicadas en cuerpo y alma a ella. Hemos estudiado durante muchísimos años en conservatorio y ahora pues tenemos la suerte de vivir exclusivamente de ella. Así que es como una relación de amor absoluta. ¿Alguien más?
No.
Here.
Here.
The origin of flamenco. The significance, it's a very difficult question because, you know, I think there are careers only to study that. What was the origin? That is really not very clear because it's a very long time ago. And it's a mix of very different cultures altogether, like from Andalusia and Arabic and Jewish. And they don't even agree, the people who are studying that, because it's something very old, and the gypsies and not gypsies, and they all want to be the beginners, you know. But it's I think the best is to read the best books about it, because we are not really we study music, not music history, so I don't want to say wrong things, but there is a lot of information very interesting about it. But what we know is that it's not very clear, you know, not the years or not the where or how it happened. I think it's something that developed little by little, you know, and only in the 19th, 20th century was something clear as flamenco like it's today. So it's difficult. Okay, so we are done here. We hope to see you tonight. Yeah, I think tonight. We will play the same songs and more. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.